Hello, my name is Marietje Schaak and I'm very sorry I cannot be present at your event today, but I'm happy to share some thoughts with you virtually on the important question of whether libraries or museums should be eligible to emulate games so that they are in general able to keep the digital heritage of Europe alive. When the copies are used only for research purposes and they are not made publicly available, these bodies should be eligible to save games for future generations, although copyright owners would be against it. Well, my simple answer would be yes, and I will share some thoughts on why I believe this should be possible. Over the last decades, video games have moved from simple computer programs to interactive audiovisual works of art sometimes that can bring together communities of people from all over the world. Video games are inherently digital and have become a driving force of technological innovation in the cultural aspects of the European digital market. And as the results of Keep show, the video game industry has developed technologies that can subsequently be used by other cultural sectors. For example, legal digital game distribution services were around way before the music and film industries had caught on. Now, for years, the European Union has acknowledged that video games are an integral part of European cultural policies. However, most initiatives so far have focused on protecting children when they're playing video games, rather than stimulating the development or the preservation of games themselves. It is great that the EU sponsors a project such as Keep, whereby the cultural status of games is properly addressed. It's important for young people and the future generation to be able to see and experience the development process of video games in Europe. The Keep project is a showcase of how an industry can overcome technological boundaries in order to share and preserve culturally significant content in a changing world. The value of preservation of video games is more than safeguarding its heritage alone. It will help to understand that development of interactive media and ICT has been a process, and the lessons learned may once again be applied when cultural industries are confused with new issues or when young generations want to learn. Therefore, I very much welcome the involvement of several memory institutions, especially that of the Koninklijke Bibliotheek for my home country, the Netherlands. Here in the European Parliament, I'm working hard to help overcome the legal obstacles for memory institutions. EU copyright does not have a suitable exception or limitation to allow a video game museum to offer the experience of old games without the permission of rights holders. Currently, the European Parliament is working on the Orphan Works Regulation, which could be a big boost for memory institutions wishing to preserve cultural heritage, including games. However, the process is taking much longer than expected because certain stakeholders are trying and succeeding to hold back the regulation and the reform. For them, reform that would reflect today's opportunities can only be a disadvantage compared to the existing laws that were drafted before digitization and internet came about. And this is a problem we have to tackle. It shows once again that European copyright needs to become more flexible to allow for new uses in the digital era. An American judge would likely have considered uses by libraries or museums of video games to be fair use. It would be helpful for us, policymakers, when the legal challenges faced by the Keep project or your community are carefully documented. Your experiences should be a part of the discussion on copyright reform and on the importance of looking for opportunities instead of threats in this discussion. So I urge you to contact me if you wish to share your experiences or ideas about how the EU can overcome the issues its cultural and technical sectors face. I also believe the music and film industries can learn from the gaming industry. We as politicians need to work together with different stakeholders to create a common understanding of how challenges of digitization, of culture can be overcome. With your hands-on experience, best practices, but also challenges you face, we can do a better job. Thank you very much.